Welcome to this AWS mini project where you're going to get experience of implementing a simple site-to-site VPN. Now, this VPN is going to be created between AWS and a simulated on-premises environment, and this means that you won't need any VPN-capable hardware to implement this mini project. Now, this is the architecture that you're going to be implementing. On the left, we have an AWS environment complete with a server running a cat-themed application. On the right, we have a simulated on-premises environment. It too has an on-premises server and a pfSense-based router. Now, pfSense is a popular firewall, router, and VPN product that you might find in many small to medium businesses. So you're going to be creating a virtual private network between this pfSense router running within the simulated on-premises environment and AWS. Now, don't worry if this looks complex, because we're going to be implementing this step by step. This is the starting state of the project, and you're going to be implementing this using a one-click deployment. So we need to go ahead and move across to the AWS console and get started. So to get started, you'll need to be logged into an AWS account with admin permissions. Now, if you're taking any one of my courses, then you should use the general AWS account, so the management account of the organization, and be logged in as the I am admin user. If you're not using one of my courses, then go ahead and use a normal AWS account, but be logged in as an I am identity with admin permissions. And as always, you'll need to complete this mini project within the Northern Virginia region. Now, attached to this video is a full set of instructions which detail step by step how to complete this mini project. And one thing that's linked within those instructions is a software subscription to the pfSense product. Now, this comes with a 30-day trial, so you won't be billed anything for the software licensing for this product, but you will need to click the link that's within the instructions before applying the one-click deployment, so make sure that you do that first. Before we get started implementing the infrastructure, there's one manual step that you'll need to do. Before we do that, though, go ahead and click on services and then type EC2 and just click this favorite icon, because we're going to be using the EC2 console often within this mini project. Do the same for the VPC console, and then lastly do the same for the CloudFormation console. Those are the three areas of the console which we'll be using constantly throughout this project. Once you've done that, click on EC2. And under Network and Security on the menu on the left, click on Key Pairs. So we're going to need to create a key pair within the Northern Virginia region. So go ahead and click on Create Key Pair. I recommend naming this one Infra for infrastructure. Assuming you're using macOS, Linux, or a modern version of Windows, you can choose PEM for the private key file format. If you're using PuTTY under Windows, you can choose PPK. I'm going to go ahead and select PEM and then click on Create Key Pair. And that's going to download part of that key to your local machine, and you'll need to use this later. Once that's created, you can go back to the main AWS console. Now, attached to the instructions for this mini project is a one-click deployment link, so go ahead and click that link. This is going to take you to a quick create stack screen. Everything should be pre-populated apart from this key pair name, and you'll need to click in this drop-down and select the key that you just created. Now, just to reiterate, you do need to have signed up for this software subscription before you can apply this template, so make sure that you have gone ahead and subscribed to this software. Again, it does come with a 30-day free trial, so you won't be billed anything for the software as part of this project. At this point, scroll down to the bottom, check this acknowledgement box, and then click on Create Stack. Now, that will take a few minutes to create, and so that's a good point to take a break and end this video. So this is going to implement this architecture, and you'll need to wait for your stack to move into a create complete state before we can continue the next stage of this mini project. So go ahead and finish the video, wait for your stack to move into create complete, and then we're good to move on to the next stage of the project.